This is 1 John 2:6. Whoever says he abides in him, abides in Jesus, ought to walk in the same way in which he, Jesus, walked. You know, Brother David, there's a lot of confusion, I think, in regards to holiness.
Right.
Some people think holiness actually is a bad thing. Sanctification, some people think it's a terrible process. Some people go to the extreme and say you have to have sinless perfection in this life now in order to be saved.
Right.
And there's the others that say, oh, well, we have grace, so it doesn't really matter how you live. How are we to understand 1 John 2:6, that whoever says he abides in Jesus ought to walk the same way in which Jesus walked?
You know, it really is the opposite of sinless perfection. They're saying there's a recognition within us that we have a standard that is higher than our own. There's a standard that takes us away from the flesh, from the rational decisions, from the law-like, I'm going to do this, I'm going to just force my way through this. Instead, the word ought says, here's a standard that actually takes you, as the psalmist says, to the place that is higher than I. Lead me to the place that is higher than I. The one that's higher than I is seen in the Lord Jesus Christ. And when we see that image of the Lord Jesus Christ, that tells me that's my goal. That's where I ought to be. And the way that Paul describes that actually is in Philippians, where he says, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. He says, I don't say that I've apprehended yet, but I want to apprehend that which I've been apprehended for. So it gives you the sense of a standard that moves you into conformity to the Lord Jesus Christ. It also tells you, I have no natural way to get there. I need a supernatural way to get there. So increasingly, we were talking about this the other day, we find that the way of Christian maturity is to become more childlike in our faith, more dependent upon the only one who can give us any resemblance, any reflection of the image of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Excellent. Amen? And very quickly, if you wouldn't mind for us, some people say, oh, that's great, I want to be Christ-like, but how do I abide in Christ? I mean, how do I do this? Would you have any short biblical advice for us?
Yeah, and I heard the word short. That's right. No, thank the Lord. We can be short. We can be simple about this.
Yeah.
David says, I have set the Lord always before me. And he says that in Psalm 16. So this idea of setting the Lord before you is to realize he's the one leading me. How can I simply arrive at that? I realize that I need to keep my eyes on him. And because of the new inclination to follow him, when I'm not following him, there's a few red flags that go up when I'm not. You know, if I'm moving to the left or the right of the center of his will, there's something inside that God gives me by his Spirit that says, there's some reproof here. There's some correction that's needed. And so thank the Lord, we can take that simplicity when David says, I have set the Lord always before me, and realize that he is the one not only goes before me, but he's also behind me. In what sense? Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, behind me, all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord. So thank the Lord for the one who leads us, but who also follows us and calls us to keep our eyes looking unto him, the author and the finisher of our faith, as the one who is the one calling us to be conformed more and more into his own image.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right.